Hey, Shalom, Israel. Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all honors and praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rekakadash. I want to give double honors to the elders and apostles, Great Millstone, for bringing out the 100% truth and keeping it real. Salutations to the 144 hopeful elect of Israel who's pushing his word in all truth and sincerity. And the 1/3 of Israel who believe in the word and follow the Lamb wherever we go. Shalom, brothers and sisters. Shalom. All praise to Yahweh Hashem Hashem, man, for this 100% truth. We're bringing it out again, you know, to the best of our abilities with the spirit that the Lord has given us. So, you know, as you can see on the screen here, I stopped yesterday, you know, in the travels, and I had to take a picture of these creatures here. You know, they're in my spot, actually. That's where I preach the word at, you know, on the live camp, you know, on the weekends, you know, on Saturdays. That's where I be at. And they saw me a while back. They saw me, like a week and a half ago, when the Spirit was on me to go down, you know, in town to the old spot. So I was down, you know, another chief place of concourse in town. And one of these, do you know who these people are? These are the Jehovah's Witness. You know, they run around normally knocking on doors and shit and, you know, proclaiming this false god and false idol, you know, so-called, you know, these false gods. And, you know, up here, what they're talking about, peace, peace when? That's right, when they say peace, peace, when there is no peace. And they're standing out here in all, you know, just wrong and all wickedness. So I had to take a picture of it. And the title of this epistle here is entitled, Leave Them Alone. Now, did I jump out my car and run up to them and say, hey, you motherfuckers are going off, you know, and start, you know, preaching to them about, you know, women shouldn't be teaching all this stuff. And look, they got the diaper face on their, they got the diaper on their face. Why? Because they don't believe in Yahweh Hashem Hashai. They believe in this world, you know, and that's why they're still out here proclaiming this Jehovah's Witness stuff, bro. Calling on another name with another doctrine. Not only them alone. We're about to get into the epistle now, bro. Not only these guys alone. Last night, I'm going to just make reference of these Mysteries of the Kingdom. Made an epistle about these guys here. You know, this is Zakari again with another rap album. It says, do you understand what you're involved in? Not only him, there's another brother that made an epistle about him too. You know, we're not going to play it, but I'll put these in the description box. You know, because, you know, this is of the world. Rap is of the world, right? You know, the Lord told us to preach this word. The Lord told us to come together on one accord, having the same mind, you know, and one doctrine, having the same doctrine, believing in his words, okay? So these guys are going off. Over here, the brother, I'll put this on the description box too. Once again, the real apologist. Christianity is losing sleep and can't accept the truth about the biblical Israelites. And this was a really beautiful epistle, brothers and sisters. So this so-called pastor here, you know, he had the doctrine on point. He had the doctrine down, you know. But as the brother was bringing out, you know, he got it down that on the, you know, to the, hey, we're the, you know, we claim to be the Israelites. We came to claim to be under the curses. He brought out some curses. He brought out brought over here to Babylon the Great, aka America, and transatlantic slave trade and slavery ships. You know, he brought all that out. You know, but as the brother, and as the title of his epistle, Christianity is losing sleep and can't accept the truth about the biblical Israelites, right? Even though everything points the finger at the so-called Negro, Hispanic, and Native American Indians being the lost 12 tribes of Israel, the Lord's chosen people. You know, and this doctrine that we have is not of ours, you know, just like Yahweh Shah said, this is not mine, it's, you know, it's to him that sent me. He is the word of Yahweh Shem HaShah, right? This is the word of Yahweh Shem HaShah, man, and that's all it is to it. So these guys, they can't accept it, you know? And what do we have here? This is about from the brother, GMS, Playtime is over. You know, it says, among my people are found wicked men. I'll put this in the description box, Lord willing, as well. And who do we have here? None other than TD Snakes. And who? And then look at this. Look what's going on here. The brother said they throwing up gangs. They throwing up the the signs, you know, that Illuminati, all that stuff that they're saying that they're in, you know, and they're part of that. They're part of that that wickedness of Esau, you know, the devil. They've sold their soul. This is Puff Daddy putting his shoulder on T.D. Snakes, bro, letting you know that they are all together. So let's get into this epistle, brothers and sisters. I want to show these people one more time. There they are. Look, she throw a waving up at me out there in the streets. But where I want to put out one more point. Where are they at? Because, you know, like I said, this is the first time I've seen these creatures ever since that plague started. You know, how long ago was that? Was that almost 2 years ago? It can't have been 2 years ago, bro. I don't know. I'm not good with time when it comes down to things like that. But I remember when the plague first hit, you know, and everything was shut down for a while. These motherfuckers got the hell out of Dodge. And so this is the first time I've seen them. And I believe they're out because they saw me out in the streets the other day preaching the word of Yahweh Shemashah. You know how it is, bro. So the title of this epistle one more time. This is the book of Matthew chapter 15, verse 14. Let them alone. They be blind leaders of the blind. And if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into the ditch. That's right, bro, because the scripture speaks about that this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness, and then shall the end come. Okay? Yeah. This is the book of Matthew chapter 24, verse 14. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world. This gospel right here, of the truth, the 100% truth of the scriptures, that we, the so-called Negro, Hispanic, and Native American Indians, are the Lord's chosen people. And this is prophecy being fulfilled, that we're going to wake up in the last days and remember who we are. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for witness unto all nations. And then shall the end come, brothers and sisters. So I want to go back here, man, one more time. Matthew chapter 15, verse 14. Let them alone. They be blind leaders of the blind. And if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into the ditch. And that goes, you know, not only for these ladies that's going off, you know, proclaiming some false god and false idol, you know, as usual, up in their harlot houses and temples made with hands, you know, bringing out a false doctrine, you know. These guys here that's out there rapping instead of proclaiming his word of truth, that's going off with their sticks and their guns and their weapons and everything, you know. When Yahweh Shemashah just told us to come out here and wait on him till he rise up to the prey, trust in him, have faith in him. You know, the angels of the Lord encamp around about them that trust in him, you know, that fear him, Salaki. You know, these guys, when it comes to these other nations, you know, that's trying to, that they have hijacked our book. You know, the Lord say, only you have I known of all the families of the earth, therefore I shall, you know, that's Amos. Only you have I known of all the families of the earth, therefore I punish you for all your transgressions. You know, the house of Jacob, their sins. And also, Psalms. Let's go get that Psalms real quick. I'm not going to bring it up. I'm going to get it on the phone. Psalms 147, verse 19. He showeth his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgment unto Israel. He have not dealt so with any nation, and it's for his judgments they have not known them. Praise ye, Yahweh Shemashah. Right, bro. So all these other nations that are trying to, what's that called? That phrase they got now? That replacement theology. That they don't care what the word of Yahweh Shemashah say. It's their religion, what they say, you know. And that's why, you know, this gospel, Matthew chapter 24, verse 14, and this gospel of the kingdom, okay, this brand new song, referring to the book of Revelation chapter 14, verse 3, this new song, this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached. Of the kingdom. You know, we're talking about a new kingdom. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. You know, because right now we understand that the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. Esau, Edom, the Caucasian race. You know, who covered the faces of the judges thereof. Who said that they're right here. Where is it at? Said that this Caucasian man is the Messiah. You know, but this new song, this gospel right here is coming back to the words of Yahweh Shemashah, which says he's got woolly hair and skin and bronze, that he's only for the children of Israel. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world You know, because the children of Israel are scattered among all nations for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. Right. So let's get into the epistle, bro. I just wanted to open it up with that. So like if it took a little bit longer than I had hoped for, we're going to go to the book of Zephaniah. Chapter 1, verse 8, straight to the point. And it shall come to pass in the day of the Lord's sacrifice that I will punish the princes and the king's children, and all such are clothed with strange apparel. That's right, man. The warning does not stop to the children of Israel, the so-called Negro, Hispanic, and Native American Indians. The warnings will not stop, you know, until the Lord bring us, you know, we're condemning this wicked-ass world, and we're warning the children of Israel, getting the blood off our hands. The warning will not stop, telling you about what times we're living in, telling them about the time of Jacob's trouble, telling them about the implementation of the M-A-R-K, you know, and telling them to repent to the one true living God. Yahweh Shemashah said, you know, at least you repent, you shall all likewise perish. So the Lord is telling you right here, once again, Zephaniah chapter 1, verse 8, and it shall come to pass in the day of the Lord's sacrifice, because the Lord is going to destroy Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America, that I will punish the princes and the king's children and all such as are clothed with strange apparel. If you, you know, listening to another doctrine, you know, and you know, I'm bringing this guy up just to make a point. Yesterday we just had, speaking about IUIC, you know, not calling on the name of Yahweh Shemashah, and of course preaching another doctrine, you know. If you're preaching another doctrine, if you're the so-called children of Israel, and you have not repented to the one true living God, if you're still cleaving onto this world, and all the wickedness that's going on in this world, Yahweh Shemashah say, and such are clothed with strange apparel, you know, he's going to punish you. And it reminds me of that scripture, friend, why comes in here without a wedding garment? You know, this right here, this understanding, this truth, you know, it's like clothing, you know. Let's go to the book of Isaiah chapter 52. I'm just going to read it off the phone, okay? Isaiah chapter 52. Awake, awake. Put on thy strength, O Zion. Put on thy beautiful garments, O Jerusalem, the holy city. For henceforth thou shalt no more come into thee the uncircumcised and unclean. Shake thyself from the dust. Arise and sit down. All that confusion. Shake yourself. Shake all that stuff off. All these different doctrines out here. All these philosophies. You know? All these worldly ways that don't make no sense. You know, they're telling you to call good evil and evil good. Shake all that stuff off. Arise and sit down. You know, this confusion. Not knowing which way to go, which way to turn. Oh shit, the gas price is going up. Oh Lord, the food is going up. What we gonna do? Hey, shake thyself from the dust. Arise and sit down, O Jerusalem. Loose thyself from the bands of thy neck, O captive daughter of Zion. Okay? It's time. Yahweh Shemashah said, ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. So once again, Zephaniah chapter 1, verse 8, and it shall come to pass in the day of the Lord's sacrifice that I will punish the princes and the king's children, and all such are clothed with strange apparel. Okay? Going to the book of Isaiah, chapter 55, verse 6. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. And let him return unto the Lord, Yahweh Shemashah, and he will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. Right. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Right. And that's why, you know, we didn't run up on these people here. You know, that's why we don't stand out across the street from churches. No, we go out on the highways and hedges. And Yahweh Shemashah is the one that directs the footsteps of men. You know, he just said, preach this word, prophesy to the wind, warn them for me. We make these epistles throughout the week. You know, we rebuke them sharply so they be sound in the faith. All of them. T.D. Jakes have been rebuked. Puff Daddy have been rebuked. You know, they know about the truth. But where they at? This message is for the 144 hopeful elect and one-third of Israel, the ones that's going to hear these words. Repent and be healed, bro. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way. Right, this truth is out now. Said letting you know, hey, that the ways of this world has taught us to go away from Yahweh Shemashah, to do things in error of the Lord, to do things contrary to the what the Lord actually likes and what he wants, how he wants us to live. The so-called Negro, Hispanic, and Native American Indians. He's given us laws, statutes, commandments that we should be abiding in. You know, Right now, we're under grace. You know, we're coming back to Yahweh Hashem Ashai, to the best of our abilities, following those laws, statutes, and commandments to the best of our abilities, but most of all, having faith and believing in Yahweh Hashem Ashai, bro. You know, first, you must believe. Let the wicked forsake his way. That when you have that faith in the Lord, absolute faith, you're automatically going to want to do the right thing. You're automatically going to want to do things to please the Lord because why? You fear him. You're trying to get, you know, protection of the Yahweh Hashem Ashai because you believe all these things that's about to come to pass. Let the wicked forsake his way. You're going to straighten your shit up and the unrighteous man his thoughts and let him return. What? Return. What? That's right. Return. Why? Because we fell away. They've fallen away. We were, you know, there with Yahweh Hashem Ashai. We're the Lord's chosen people, but then we fled. You know, we were now we're Gentiles. You know, out here in all these other nations, scattered among all people, learning the ways and philosophies and doctrines of these other nations. But the Lord has given us these laws, statutes, and commandments. He gave them to the chosen Israel, just like we just read. He showeth His word unto Jacob, His statutes and judgment unto Israel. He has not done so with any other nation. And as for his judgments, they have not known them. Praise ye Yahweh Hashem Ashai, right? Those are for the children of Israel only. So let him return unto those laws, statutes, and commandments that the Lord has given them. To that understanding that we're his chosen people. Unto the Lord. And he will have mercy upon him. And to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. Right? These other nations never received that. You know, what is guy at? What's his picture at? These other nations here. Now they got a false, they done hijacked our book. You know, all laws, statutes, and commandments, but they're not doing them. You know, they throw away the Sabbath day because it's not for them. You know, they're of this world, bro. They're heathens. This word is for the children of Israel only. So look, seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near, brothers and sisters. And that's why these warnings are going out. Because the Lord is going to, what does he say? Punish all the children in strange apparel. All the ones that don't believe. 2 Chronicles chapter 15 verse 3. Hold on, bro. This is not right. This is what I wanted. This is not what I was looking for. Hold on. Okay, here it is. Salaki 15 verse 13. That whosoever would not seek the Lord, Yahweh Hashem Ashai, God of Israel, should be put to death, whether small or great, whether man or woman. So you understand that? It's plain. Whosoever would not seek the Lord, Yahweh Hashem Ashai, God of Israel, not no false god or no false idol that says he loves everybody, should be put to death, whether small or great, whether man or woman. Okay? Let's go to the book of 2 Ezra, chapter 15, verse 1. Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of what? Prophecy, things that are going to come to pass, which I will put in thy mouth, said the Lord, Yahweh Hashem Ashai, and cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true. Fear not the imaginations against thee. Let not the incredulity of them trouble thee that speak against thee. That's right, man. Don't worry about what nobody say. False prophet right here. Don't let him, you know, say, don't worry about him. These guys here, these wicked men right here, among my people are found wicked men, right, bro? Don't let them worry. Don't worry about them, what they're going to say. These guys here that's going off, that say they in the truth, that say they are high priests and everything, but they out here rapping, you know. And, of course, these women that the Lord say they should keep silence in the church. Don't worry about what they're going to say. Let them go on out here. What do we read? What's the name of this epistle? Let them alone. They be blind leaders of the blind. And if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into the ditch. Why? Because this gospel right here is for the 144 hopefully elect and 130 Israel at this time. So fear not the imaginations against thee. Let not the incredulity of them trouble thee. That incredulity is disbelief that speak against thee. For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. That's right here, bro. All the unfaithful shall, what? Die in their unfaithfulness. That's right, man. You think you're playing around? You think the Lord playing around? He said he's going to punish all the ones in strange apparel. Behold, said the Lord, Yahweh Shem HaShah, I will bring plagues upon the world. Now we're seeing all these plagues happening right here in real time. You know, creeping up. Scripture speaks about it. And even then shall many evils multiply upon the earth, bro. Behold, said the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction. For wickedness have exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hurtful works are fulfilled. Therefore, said the Lord, Yahweh Shem HaShah, I will hold, so like it, bro. I will hold my tongue no more as touching their wickedness, which they profanely commit, neither will I suffer them in those things in which they wickedly exercise themselves. Behold, the innocent and righteous blood crieth unto me, and the souls of the just complain continually. And therefore, said the Lord, Yahweh Shem HaShah, I will surely avenge them and receive unto me all the innocent blood from among them. Okay? Let's go to the book of Isaiah, chapter 65, verse 13. Therefore, thus said the Lord, Yahweh Shem HaShah, behold, my servant shall eat, but ye shall be hungry. Behold, my servant shall drink, but ye shall be thirsty. Behold, my servant shall rejoice, but ye shall be ashamed. Right, man. This is prophecy. This is prophecy being, you know, prophecy that's about to be fulfilled, man. He's going to send the famine. He's going to send all these plagues. He's going to send the sword, which is Esau, Edom. You know, the Caucasian race. The devil that the Bible speaks of. They're doing the will of the Lord. In one way or the other. Therefore, thus said the Lord, Yahweh Shem HaShah, behold, my servant shall eat, but ye shall be hungry. Yeah, the ones that have returned, have seek the Lord's face and is serving him. That have faith in him, that believe in him. The ones that's preaching his word. The ones that's doing everything they can to please Yahweh Shem HaShah. The servants shall eat, but ye shall be hungry. Behold, my servant shall drink, but ye shall be thirsty. Behold, my servant shall rejoice, but ye shall be ashamed. Behold, my servant shall sing for joy of heart, but ye shall cry for sorrow of heart and shall howl for vexation of spirit. We're going to leave it right there, bro. Let's go to the book of 1 Timothy. Right. Speaking about, so, you know, now listen, brothers, I hope I didn't let the cat out of the bag too soon when we spoke about this Isaiah chapter 65, verse 13. You know, now we're going to get back into it. We're going to go back a little bit. I wanted to get this 1 Timothy, just bring it back, you know, to where we at now. With these women right here going off, you know. 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 12. But I suffer not a woman to teach, nor usurp authority over the man, but to be in silence. Okay? Look, verse 11. Let the woman learn in silence with all subjection. Right, you're not supposed to be out there talking about, you know, and then what what's all this stuff out here? You know, the Lord said, the Bible needs no other mate. You know, you don't need no other books. Of course, every now and then we, you know, dig into a history book here and there, you know, or a commentary here and there. But the Bible needs no other mate. Everything is written in there, was written aforetime for our learning, bro. So we, through comfort and faith of the scriptures, might have hope, okay? Let's go to the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 4. For he that cometh preaching another Jesus, whom we have not preached, you know, and his real name is Yahweh Shai. So, you know, right off the bat, if he that cometh preaching another Yahweh Shai, right, but the world ignorantly calls him JC because they don't know the name of the Lord. But the Lord has blessed us with this truth, with this understanding, whom we have not preached. So when we, you know, coming on the four corners of the earth, this gospel being preached, this new song brought forth by the elders, apostles, great millstone, and all the other brothers on there in their umbrella, you know, with that 100% truth, through the spirit and the power of Yahweh Shem HaShah, you know, telling you what time we're living in, with the end of this age, the end of this kingdom, you know, that's the earth is given into the hand of the wicked, Esau, Edom, the Caucasian race, you know, telling you that this, you know, the time of Jacob's trouble is at hand, you know, the beginning of sorrows here, And we see it with the food prices going off, with the, you know, with the reports of them destroying crops, killing animals and livestock, you know, bringing on this famine, you know. So if someone is coming preaching another Yahweh Shai, which, who's Yahweh Shai? The spirit of Yahweh Shai is the spirit of prophecy. He's the word of Yahweh Hashem HaShai, whom we have not preached. Or if you receive another spirit, you know, other than the spirit of truth, which ye have not received, or another gospel, right? All these prosperity doctrines, or these worldly doctrines over here, you know what I'm saying? Or this God loves everybody doctrine over here. This give me your money doctrine, you know? So like it, bro. I just gotta, okay, let's go back to it. So like it. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 4. For if he that cometh preaching another Yahweh Shai, whom we have not preached, or if ye receive another spirit which you have not received, or another gospel which ye have not accepted, ye may well bear with him. Okay? You might as well put up with it, because this 100% truth is on display. You know? This is the book of Matthew chapter 24, verse 14. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come, brothers and sisters. You know? So like it, bro. They were trying to distract me over here. Come on, let's get back into it. Let's go to the book of John, chapter 3, verse 20. John chapter 3, verse 23, Salaki. Ye are from beneath, I am from above. Ye are of this world, I am not of this world. And you see, this is in the red letter. These are the words of Yahweh Shai, the Messiah. I said therefore unto you, that ye shall die in your sins. For if ye believe not that I am he, ye shall die in your sins. And we're talking about the one true living God. We're not talking about no false god and false idols. So no more, bro. That's all that's done. All that worshiping in them damn our harlot houses that's been teaching us lies all this time, are telling us to celebrate these pagan ass holidays and all this stuff. Then said they unto him, who art thou? And Yahweh Shai said unto them, even the same that I say unto you from the beginning. I have many things to say and to judge of you, but he that sent me is true, and I speak to the word, to the world, those things which I have heard of him. They understood not that he spoke to them of the Father. Then said Yahweh Shai unto them, when ye have lifted up the Son of Man, then shall ye know that I am he, and that I do nothing of myself, but as my Father have taught me, I speak these things. And he that sent me is with me, and the Father have not left me alone, for I do always those things that please him, bro. You see that? So, we, you know, just like Yahweh Shai, the Messiah, you know, he said, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me, you know. As a stripper in the book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 12, verse 13, man's all is to serve Yahweh Shema Shai, bro. And that's what we understand now, and that's why we're coming back wholeheartedly to this 100% truth. Wholeheartedly believing and having faith in Yahweh Shema Shai, bro. Oh, hey, brothers and sisters, let's see. We're going to keep it going, bro. We're going to go to the book of John chapter 3, verse 20. For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest their deeds should be reproved. Right, once again, this gospel right here, letting you know, hey, this is the way, walk ye in it. You know, and once again, we've corrected, we've rebuked. You know, but once again, this word is for the 144 hopefully elect and one-third of Israel, bro. Where are them people at? Where they at? There you go. That's them. But what? For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light. They rather worship a false god and a false idol, man, and tell them they can do this, they can be a part of this wicked ass world. You know, they can go along to get along instead of separating themselves what the Lord called for, you know, to do his will, like we just read in the book of John over here. And he that sent me is with me, and the Father have not left me alone, for I do always those things that please him, man. And that's what we're trying to be right here. We're trying to do the same thing so the Lord don't leave us, man. So he don't, you know, take his spirit away from us, brothers and sisters. You know what I'm saying? For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest their deeds should be reproved. But he that doeth truth cometh to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest, that they are wrought in Yahweh Shemashah, man. And that's what we're talking about. We've tasted of this wonderful blessing of truth, man. We've tasted it. And we don't want no part of this wicked ass world no more. So we're coming to Yahweh Shemashah more and more, you know, daily. You know, coming to him praying, you know, weeping with mourning, with supplication, and asking Yahweh Shemashah to keep us, man. Keep us away from this wicked ass world and protect us from our enemy. This is the book of Matthew chapter 11, verse 6. And blessed is he whosoever shall not be offended in me, my man. That's what we're talking about right there, you see. Because we don't care what you just read earlier in the book of 2 Ezra. Fear not the incredulity of them, you know, that speak against thee. You know, don't worry about them. Don't worry about their unbelief. So, blessed is he whosoever shall not be offended in me. So, we know that the Lord, you know, speaks against this wicked-ass world. You know, just like Jeremiah chapter 28, verse 8, the prophets that had been before me and before thee of old, roughly paraphrasing, both preach against wicked, speak against great kingdoms of war and of evil and of pestilence, man, because we're ushering in the kingdom of heaven over here, okay? We're speaking about the things that are to come, telling you that this world here, this is the end of this age, telling you that the leaders of this society are all wicked, you know, Esau, Edom, the Caucasian race, these are the people that the Lord hates, you know, not to be a part of this wicked world, telling you who these people are, bro. They're the devil that the Bible speaks of. We're not ashamed or we're not offended in Yahweh Shemashah. Understanding that he said, let's go get it in the book of Daniel. So I don't want to mess it up, bro. Daniel. Chapter 12, verse 10. You know, we're not offended in this. Many shall be purified. That's right. Many shall be purified and made white and tried. But the wicked shall do wickedly, and none of the wicked shall understand. But the wise shall understand. We're not offended in these words that say, hey, there's going to be wicked Jake still out here, you know, that know they're Israelites, you know, but they're still going off. Wicked Jakes that know they're Israelites, but they're still going off. You know, they're still of this world. We're not offended in the word of Yahweh Shemashah, bro. That's what we're talking about over here. All praise to Yahweh Shemashah. So let's read this one more time before we move on. And blessed is he whosoever shall not be offended in me. We're not offended that Yahweh Shemashah said 2/3 of the children of Israel will be cut off and die. We're not offended that the words say, hey, lest ye repent, ye shall all likewise perish. We're not offended to say that, hey, this world, Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America, is about to be destroyed with nuclear warheads, you know, because we believe in Yahweh Shemashah. This is the book of Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. Right. For he that cometh to Yahweh Shemashah must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that what? That diligently seek him. And what did we say earlier? Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near, bro. You know? But what? But without faith, you know, it is impossible to please him, right? Because we're going to do, you know, if you got that faith, you're going to be doing the will of the Lord. Whether it be, if he called you to preach, you're going to be out there preaching on the highways and hedges. You know, if he called you to be a believer, you're going to be believing wholeheartedly. If he called you to be a helper, you're going to be helping. know what I'm talking about, brothers and sisters, man? But without faith, your ass gonna be sitting over here in the chair saying that the vision is yet for a far off. You know, those things you're talking about, that stuff ain't gonna happen, man. That's what you're gonna be saying if you don't have faith in this word. You see the implementation of the MARK, but no, you know, that just, you know, that can't be the prophecy. Not really. You know, it's not gonna get that bad. They're just trying to, this is a future. This is future technology here coming, you know. You're not gonna believe it. So what the scripture said, we just read, you know, my servant shall eat, but ye shall be hungry, right? The Lord's talking about coming as a thief in the night, because this warning is out, telling the children of Israel what time we're living in. But without faith is it impossible to please him. For he that cometh to Yahweh Shemashah must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him, bro. That's right, bro. If you know, you got to believe it, man. This is the book of Habakkuk, chapter 2, verse 3. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Right, man, this vision. All these prophecies that's in the scriptures, man, are coming to life right before our very eyes. This is the end. There's many antichrists out here. Let us know that it is the end. You know, we've woken up to the truth. You know, after that falling away of calm, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 3. You know what I'm saying? We've woken up to the truth. We understand who we are now. We understand who the devil that the Bible speaks of is. Blessed are your eyes to see, bro. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Right, man. And I had a conversation earlier today. And I was like, yeah, you know, just like what we just mentioned. This is that time that all these things are to be fulfilled, because we have woken up to the truth. And what does 2 Thessalonians say? For that day shall not come, except that come a falling away first. That falling away has come, and now we're once again standing upon our feet proclaiming these words that these things are going to come to pass. Right? For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Right? And so now it's so close to it. But it may seem like it's tearing around, but it's not tearing, bro. Though it tarry, wait for it. It will surely come. It will not tarry, bro. It's about to be fulfilled right now, bro. All praises to Yahweh Shemashah. We're about to go home. Let's go to the book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 2. And be not conformed to this world, right? Understanding that. Let's start at one, man. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of Yahweh Shemashah, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice. Right. Going right back to Ecclesiastes in the Bible. Chapter 12, verse 13. Man's all is to serve the Lord. As Yahweh Shah say, hey, I've come to do the will of my Father, Yahweh, which is to proclaim this 100% truth and be that sacrifice, be that living sacrifice. So we right behind Yahweh Shah, bro. So right now, we're dead to this world. We've made ourselves a living sacrifice. We're dead to this world. We're in the world, but not a part of it. We're not plugged into this society. We're not trying to get in this place. No, we understand that we're just servants here. We're slaves here until Yahweh Shemashah come and deliver us out of the hands of our enemies. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of Yahweh Shemashah, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice. Holy, that means separate, bro. Pure, sanctified, set apart, acceptable unto Yahweh Shemashah, which is your reasonable service. We're supposed to be doing this because we are the Lord's chosen people. And be not conformed to this world. You know, don't be all tied up in being one of these motherfuckers that's, you know, standing out there with the damn heathen, you know, proclaiming a false god and a false idol, you know, and temples made with hands. We are the temple of Yahweh Shemashah. You know, don't be a part of this world running out here rapping and stuff, or, you know, holding hands with the heathen, trimming your ways to seek love, trusting in this wicked ass world, going down to Egypt for help. No, man, we're coming back to Yahweh Shemashah, believing in these prophecies, believing in the word of Yahweh Shemashah, and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. That's right, man. Be reborn. Be converted. Be fully persuaded. Changed by the washing of this word through the spirit and the power of Yahweh Shemashah, bro. That ye may prove that which is good and acceptable and perfect will of Yahweh Shemashah, bro. Let's go to the book of Isaiah. Chapter 8, verse 20. To the law and to the testimony. If they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light in them. Right, this word that we're speaking in right now. To the law all the way to the Old Testament, all the way to the New Testament, you know. If they speak not according to this word, there's no light in them. They don't know what the hell they're talking about. You know what I'm saying? They're still speaking about that all those lies and all these different philosophies and doctrines of this world. But this is a new song right here, bro. Come on, y'all. Let's go. Let's go to the book of Matthew chapter 15, verse 24. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Right, bro. Coming back to this 100% truth of the scriptures that's written down, believing in his word. Not what they taught you, not the traditions of men, not what they say, not that replacement theology and all that stuff. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. But these motherfuckers want to blaspheme the name of Yahweh Shemashiah and call him a liar. No, you're for all people. You know how they get down, bro. This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 64. And the Lord shall scatter thee among all people. Right, so the children of Israel, his chosen people, the so-called Negro, Hispanic, and Native American Indians, are scattered among all people, all over the four corners of the earth. That's why this gospel is being preached on the four corners of the earth, so it can reach the ears of the 144 hopefully elect and one-third of Israel that's scattered among these people, among these nations. And the Lord shall scatter thee among all people, from one end of the earth even to the other. And there thou shalt serve other gods, which neither thou nor thy fathers have known, even wood and stone. Okay? That's right, man. These are the curses that we're under. So this is the time to come back and repent, understanding and believing this word. This is the book of Acts, chapter 5, verse 30. And Yahweh Shemashiah of our fathers raised up Yahweh Shai, whom ye slew and hang on a tree. Him have Yahweh exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, to give repentance to who? Israel. And forgiveness of sins. Right? Israel are the ones that received the law, such commandments, not the other nations. He came and laid his life down, brothers and sisters, to be a prince and a savior. For to give repentance, to tell them to return, you know, this grace period, to seek the Lord's face while he may be found. Come back to him, amend your ways, you know. Only acknowledge your offense. To who? Israel. Not nobody else. Not in the whole world. But see, once again, these doctrines of men, these philosophies, these lies, they want to make Yahweh Shemashiah a liar and say, no, he came to give repentance to everybody. Because they don't care. They don't care what the word say, because the word is not for them. Let's break it down. Let's get a little bit more understanding. This is the book of James, chapter 1, verse 1. James, a servant of Yahweh Shemashiah and our Lord Yahweh Shai, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greetings. Right. To the who? The whole Bible is written to the children of Israel only. Once again, we read it in the book of Psalms, chapter 147, verse 19. He showeth his word unto Jacob, his statutes and commandments to Israel. He has not dealt so with any nation. And as for his judgments, they have not known them. Praise Yahweh Shemashiah. So we just wanted to bring this little piece out, because all the whole Bible is written to the children of Israel. James, a servant of Yahweh Shemashiah and the Lord Yahweh Shai, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greetings. Scattered abroad, once again, connecting the dots. Let's go to the book of 1 John, chapter 16, verse 1. We want to read this real quick, bro. And then, now, this is in the NLT. Okay? I have told you these things so that you won't abandon your faith. I have told you these things so you will not abandon your faith. For ye will be expelled from the synagogues, and the time is coming when those who kill you think they are doing a holy service for Yahweh. Right, man, because we're not of this world. We're not down with the program of this wicked, wicked world, man. And all these lies that they promote. You know, now we're sanctified. We're made holy. And we understand the truth. And we're set free from all this stuff. So we're not down with the program no more. And what the scriptures say? Truth faileth. And them that part from evil maketh themselves a prey. Right? So when you separate yourself, you know, and the Lord called you out of this darkness into this marvelous light, you understand and you see, hey man, this place is wicked, this place is evil. Everything that these people are doing, you know, they're going off. We can't roll with that because what the scriptures say, be not unequally yoked with non-believers. He said, can two walk together unless they be agreed? All these things, man. For you will be expelled from the synagogues, and the time is coming when those who kill you would think they are doing a holy service for Yahweh Shemashah. This is because they have never known the Father or me. Yes, I'm telling you these things now, so that when they happen, you will remember my warning. Okay, when we wake up in the regeneration, you know? What do they call it? Reincarnation, bro. Yeah. Yes, I'm telling you these things now so that when they happen, you will remember my warning. I didn't tell you earlier because I was going to be with you for a while longer. But now I am going away to the one who sent me, and not one of you is asking where I am going. Instead, you grieve because of what I've told you. But in fact, it is best for you that I go away, because if I don't, the advocate won't come. You know, the comforter. The Holy Spirit, if I do go away, then I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will convict the world of its sin and of God's, Yahweh's righteousness and of the coming judgment. That's right, man. Convict. I've learned this from the brothers. This thing right here, you can click it and it should say look up. Is it going to do it now? It's not going to do it for me. Why is it not going to do it for me? Let's see. Let me see if I can do it. It does it on the phone. I don't know, bro. Let's look it up right here, tools, real quick. Convict. I brought it up earlier. Just wanna. Come on now. Reprove, rebuke. To convict, refute, confute, generally with a suggestion or shame of a person's convicted. By conviction, to bring to the light, to expose, to find fault with, correct by word, to reprehend severely, child, admonish, reprove, to call to account, show one his fault, demand an explanation by deed, to chastise, to punish, okay? Right, man, to convict. Because it's about that time for judgment, okay? And when he comes, he will convict the world of its sin, bro. Because they done took the scriptures. They done blasphemed the name of the Lord. They, like Psalms chapter 50 speaks about, they cast the words of the Lord behind them. Like the few scriptures we just read, the Lord said, I was only sent for the lost sheep of the house of Israel. They don't care what the words say. They let our dead bodies lay in the street. The so-called Negro, Hispanic, and Native American Indians. They didn't tell us who we were. You know, and yet we yet this day in our captivity. They're oppressing the poor. They're running the world in all wickedness. They're destroying the earth. On and on and on. And this is all through the spirit and the power of Yahweh Shemashah. And when he comes, he will convict the world of his sins and of Yahweh Shemashah's righteousness and of the coming judgment, bro. Okay? So we're telling the world, we're condemning this wicked world, telling them, you know, they're about to be overran. They're about to be destroyed. All these heathens are going to go into captivity. You know? He that leadeth in captivity shall go into captivity. The chief house of Esau, Edom, the Caucasian race, and all these other nations. The world's sin is that it refuses to believe in me. Righteousness is available because I go to the Father, and ye see me no more. Judgment will come because the ruler of this world has already been judged. That's right. It was already written that the Lord's going to destroy these people and throw them down. He said, for this same, what does scripture say? The Lord created all things for his good pleasure. Yea, even the wicked for the day of evil, bro. Okay, so the Lord created them for the day of evil. The Lord said, because this same purpose I have raised thee up, so I may show my mighty power in thee. This is the story. The Lord declared the end from the beginning. And it's a beautiful thing. All praise to Yahweh Shemashah. The Lord said, I will do nothing until he reveal his secrets unto his servants, the prophets. Amos chapter 3, verse 7. You know, judgment will come because the ruler of this world has already been judged, bro. There is so much more I want to tell you, but you can't bear it now, you know? When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all truth. He will not speak of his own, but will tell you what he has heard. He will tell you about the future, brothers and sisters. And that's what we're talking about, the spirit of prophecy. We're going to leave it right there. And that was John chapter 16, verse 1 through 13 in the NLT, you know, the blue letter. Now let's go to the book of Luke. I'm about to wrap it up, brothers and sisters. Actually, this is the last scripture right here. Luke chapter 18, verse 8. I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. That's right. He's going to come and deliver us out of the hands of our enemies, bro, and usher in the kingdom of heaven. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, shall he find faith on the earth, brothers and sisters? And the answer is yes. The 144 hopeful elect and 1/3 of Israel are going to be waiting patiently on Yahweh Shemashah. I'm going to be praying to the Lord to deliver out of all our troubles, understanding and believing in his word that this is the beginning of sorrows. This is the time of Jacob's trouble, when he's going to come back and judge this world for all their sins, brothers and sisters. So with that, hopefully this was edifying. I want to give all honors and praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Rekakadash. I want to give double honors to the Elders and Apostles Great Millstone for bringing out the 100% truth and keeping it real. Salutations to the 144 hopeful elect of Israel who's pushing his word in all truth and sincerity. And the 1/3 of Israel who believe in the word and follow the Lamb wherever we go. Shalom, Israel. Shalom. Leave him alone.